What about timing issues? Another common flaw allowing a window of opportunity for attackers is to attack between known events. A fairly common attack is a time of check, time of use event, sometimes referred to as TOC/TOU event. Now, what happens between the time of check and the time of use may very well be looking for a file to see if that file is on your disk. Then you return to the program, and then a few instructions later, go out and actually open the file. Well, between the time you check to see if the file exists and then you actually open the file, the user may have made a decision and sat at the terminal for several minutes and then decided, yes, I want to open this file. Well, that's a huge amount of time that an attacker could realize that it's time for me, the person has checked and they've looked for the file name, now I can substitute my file for their file and they're actually opening a file that I want them to open. Or if they're about to save a file, while they're validating the file name, if there's a window of opportunity between the time of check and the time of use, you could actually have them check, do a security check on the file, but before they physically save it, replace it with your own location or your own file pointer, and they can end up writing their file to a place that you have specified, perhaps your own directory, thereby bypassing many, many elements of your security policy. Anytime the state changes, the system state changes from one state to another state, you want to reduce the time of check and time of use delta and try to close that window up as much as possible. Also, communication disconnects. Make sure that whenever you have a distributed application to where you have the application running on one machine and a data source perhaps residing on a separate machine, you're communicating back and forth. Whenever you shut down that communication, make sure you do so in a proper fashion and don't leave open ports. Another favorite attack technique is to go find open ports or force a client to disconnect and then hijack that port, because ports are typically open in a secure fashion in many cases, and once it's been open, it's not as common to have every request to be validated. In secure systems, every request will be validated, but in less secure systems, an open port may be an open window that you can get into a system through.